Nice weather we are having.
Yes.
Well,
you may sit down if you like.
Are you sure? I don't want to interrupt you, really.
Really? Sit. I would like very much to have you do so. The light is too bad for reading. I would prefer to talk.
Well, if you insist. You know, you've gotten the strongest card I've ever seen. Honest. I had my own since yesterday.
Yesterday?
Didn't know somebody was bowled over by those pretty lamps of yours. Is you Hanisako?
Whoever you are, you must remember that I am a lady. I will excuse the remark you have just made, because the mistake was doubtless not an unnatural one in your circle. I asked you to sit down. If the invitation must constitute me your Hanisako, consider it withdrawn.
Sorry, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to offend you. I just thought, well, I mean, the girls in parks, you know, that it, of course, you don't know about.
Abandon the subject if you please. Of course, I know.
Right.
Now, tell me about these people passing and crowding each way along this path. Where are they going? Why are they hurrying so? Are they happy?
It is interesting for them, isn't it? It's a wonderful drama, right? Some are going to supper and some to other places. One can't help but wonder the histories are.
Yes, how fascinating they seem to me, rushing over their petty little dreams and their common worries. I come here to sit, because here only can I be near the great, common, throbbing heart of humanities. My part in life is cast where its beating never felt. Can you surmise why I spoke to you, Mr.
Parking Sector? And your name?
No. You'd recognize it immediately. It is simply impossible to keep one's name out of papers or even one's portrait. This heart, my maid, of course, is my only protection. They furnish me with an inkok. You should have seen the chauffeur staring when he thought I did not see. Candidly, there are five or six names belonging to Holy of Holies, and mine, by the accident of birth, is one of them. I spoke to you, Mr. Stackenbot.
Parkinsacker.
Mr. Parkinsacker, because I wanted to talk with a natural man. A real man, one unspoiled by the despicable growth of wealth and supposed social superiority. Oh, you have no idea how wary I am of it. Money, 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 and of the men who surround me, dancing like little marionettes, all cut from the same patterns. I am sick of pleasure, of joys, of travel, of society, of luxuries, of all of kinds.
I always have the other that. Money must be a pretty good thing.
A competency to be desired, certainly. But when you have so many millions of that, it is the monotony of that pose. Drives, dinners, theaters, balls, suppers, balls, dinners, more balls, forms of dinners and suppers with a gilding of superfluous wealth over it all. Sometimes, the very tinkle of mice in my champagne glass nearly drives me mad.
I've always liked to read up on the habits and customs of the wealthy class. I have myself a bit of connoisseur on the subject. But I like to have my information accurate. Now, I have formed the opinion that champagne is cool in the bottle, not by placing ice in the glass.
You must understand that We of non-useful class depend for our amusement upon departure from president. Just now, it is a fact, put ice in champagne. The idea was originated by a visiting prince of Tartary while down at the Waldorf. It will send your way to some of the fin. Just as, at the dinner party this week on Madison Avenue, a glinting glow was read by the play of each guest to be put on and used by tin leaves.
I see.
These special diversions of the inner circle do not become familiar to the common public, of course.
Of course, it's all quite fascinating. I've always wanted to participate in, or at least witness firsthand, the rituals of the rite.
We are drawn to that which we do not understand.
I guess that's true.
For my part, I have always thought that if I should ever love a man, it would be one of lowly station. One who is a worker, not a gerund, but doubtless and cleansed of a curse and what we prove stronger than my inclination. Just now, I'm besieged by two suitors. One is Grand Duke of German Principality. I think he has or has had a wife somewhere driven mad by his intemperance and cruelty. The other is English Marcus, so cold and mercenary that I prefer even the vertical nature of the Duke. What it is that impels me to tell you these things, Mr. Parkinwalker?
Against Tucker.
Of course.
I don't know why you should be a common man like me, but you can't know how much I appreciate your confidences.
What is your line of business, if you don't mind my asking?
A very humble one, but I hope to rise in the world someday.
You have aspirations.
Oh yes, there's so much I want to do.
I admire your enthusiasm. I, myself, can find very little to be enthused about, burdened as I am by the constant pleasures and diversions of my class.
Did you really mean it before, when you said you could love a man of lowly station?
Indeed, I did. But I said might.
Why only might?
Well, there is Grand Duke and Marcus to think of, you know?
But you said yourself, they are so cold.
I'm sure you understand when I say there are certain expectations of a young lady in my position. It would be such a disappointment for the certain members of my family if I were to marry a commoner, as we like to call them. You simply cannot imagine the scandal it would cause. All the magazine is remarked upon it. I might even be cut off from the family fortune. And yet, no calling could be too humble were the man I loved or that I wish him to be.
I work in a restaurant.
Not as a waiter? Labor is no work, but personal attendance, you know? Ballets and...
Not a waiter. I'm a cashier in that restaurant over there.
That... the one there? The one?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Quite sure.
But... oh!
What is it? What's wrong?
I'm late for the important engagement.
An engagement?
Yes.
Some sort of...
Yes, yes.
Will I see again?
I didn't know. Perhaps. But the film may not sense me again. I must go quickly now. There is dinner in a box at the play. And oh, the same all around. Perhaps you noticed an automobile at the upper corner of the park as you came. One with a white body.
An Wrriten gear?
Yes. I always come in that. Pierre waits for me there. He supposes me to be shopping in the department store at Lossa Square. Conceive of the bondage of the life we're in. We must deceive even our chauffeurs. Good night.
Wait! It's getting dark, and the park is full of questionable characters. Can't I walk to the...
No! I mean, no. If you have the slightest legal formal wishes, You will remain on this bench for 10 minutes after I have left. I do not mean to question your intentions, but autos generally bear the monogram of their owner. Again, good night.
Billy Jane, Papa! What on earth are you doing out here? Don't you know what time it is?
To whom are you speaking, madame?
To whom am I? To you! Who do you think? You meaning?
Then, I'm sure I don't know what you're talking about.
Your shift started 15 minutes ago. This Mr. Witherspoon's in a late. This is the third time you've been late. You'd better get yourself over there and into uniform before he cuts you loose for good.
I just...
Go on now. I know, you can't afford to miss a paycheck.
You must have me confused with someone else.
Confused with? Why, Mary Jane Parker? We've known each other for 3 years. We swap shifts. Have you been drinking? Why are you wearing that ridiculous hat?
I'm sorry, Mr. Parking Blogger.
Parking Stacker.
Parking Stacker.
Parking Stacker?
Yes, Parking Stacker.
As in the Parking Stacker from the society pages?
The society pages?
You only ever support it.
You must excuse me. My chauffeur is waiting.
Chauffeur? What kind of crazy ears are you putting on? You've never had a chauffeur in your life. You don't even own an automobile.
I do so.
Since when?
Since? Oh, get away from me. I don't know you.
Don't know me? You've been drinking. I'm going to tell your mother.
Wait, you forgot.
Begging your pardon, sir.
Is Henry?
I don't mean to intrude, but your dinner reservation is... Shall I cancel, or...?
No, I'm coming.
What can I do for you, sir? Would you like me to get it back to her?
No.
Very good, sir. The auto is waiting.